Welcome back to my channel. As always, my name is Joy, and in this video, I believe I have another prophetic word, a continuation to my previous video, Victory is Here. As always, when it's a prophetic word, it's not meant for everybody. You do want to test the spirit, take this video back to the Lord, pray about it, and let Him confirm the word for you. As always, thank you so much for being subscribed to my channel. Thank you so much for all your encouragement. Thank you so much for all your support. If you have not subscribed, I don't know what you're waiting for, but go ahead and hit that subscribe button and make sure to click on that notification bell. That way you can't be notified when I do post new videos. So I'll go ahead and jump right into this message. In my last video, I talked about victory, right? I talked about victory is here. And I know for the people who receive that as their confirmation, you've probably been asking God, you said victory is here, but I'm not seeing it yet. Like, when is it gonna happen? How long must I wait? Like, what's going on, God? And as you can tell from the title of this video, I've been praying to God and I've been spending time with Him and I've been asking Him, God, when? Right? And I strongly believe that what I heard the Lord telling me was about this time next year, right? And you know when the Lord speaks to you, and He speaks to us in all different ways. For me, He does usually confirm His word via scripture. He confirmed to me via scripture, using a scripture that I want to jump into. And it is 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 16. And this is about the Shunem woman. And what that scripture says, that particular verse says, it says, next year, about this time, you will be holding a son in your arms, right? And that is the New Living Translation. And the King James Version actually says, about this time next year, you will be holding a son in your arms. And the woman, that's Elisha speaking to this woman, and the woman responded and she said, no, my Lord, she cried, oh man of God, don't deceive me. Don't get my hopes up like that, right? So this woman, when we look into her story, she was a wealthy woman. She was a woman who was married. And when Elisha used to pass by her town, you know, she invited him to come over and spend the evening with her and her husband, eat food with them. She even went to the extent of building a room for the man of God, Elisha, right? And she never asked for anything. She never expected anything. And Elisha was so touched by what she had done for him that he asked his servant, Gehazi, what can we do for this woman? And he tried to reward the woman. Can I put in a good word for you to, you know, the king? And she was like, no, I'm good. Like, I'm good. But when I read the story of this woman and the revelation that I was getting, it was this woman had probably gotten to a place where she had expected, she had hoped, she had prayed about it probably, and God just had not blessed her with that son. So when the man of God is telling her about this time next year, you're gonna have a son, she's crying out and she is saying, no, like, no, man of God, like, don't deceive me. Don't get my hopes up. Don't let me expect what I can't have. Because for her, it was impossible. For her, it was impossible. And when I kept spending time with God and asking Him, you know, what does this mean? Like, give me, like, I'm one of those people. I'm like, God, all right, give me another sign. Give me another sign. Right? The other verse that I got is Genesis 18 and 14. And this is concerning Abraham and Sarah. And this is a prophet that comes to, or an angel that comes to Abraham and tells Abraham that he's gonna have a child. And he was older, right? And Sarah was eavesdropping, you know, she was eavesdropping. She was like, let me hear what this man is over here telling my husband, right? So she was eavesdropping, and in her mind, when the man told her, you know, you're gonna have a child, she was like, he's old, like I'm old, like what? Like, what do you mean? And she laughed, because to her it just seemed impossible, right? And Genesis 18:14 says, is anything too hard for God? I will return about this time next year, and Sarah will have a son. Now, I know for some of you, you're probably like, well, that's talking about, you know, having children. I'm over here praying to God about my business. I'm over here praying to God about, you know, marriage. I'm over here praying to God about restoration. I'm over here praying to God for a different kind of breakthrough. But God is telling you, and this is why I told you, if this message is for you, you have to take it back to the Lord and let him confirm it for you. But what this word is saying is, about this time next year, you are going to start walking into your blessing. You are going to receive what you have been praying for. You are going to see the anointing of God. You are going to experience the miracles that God has been promising you. And I just want to let you know, if you continue reading the book of Elisha, 2 Kings chapter 4, and continue on to verse 17, you will notice that it says that that woman went in and had relations with her husband, and she conceived a child. Now, I don't want you to just take this prophetic message and say, well, I'm just gonna lay back, I'm not gonna do anything, because I already got my confirmation. About this time next year, God is just gonna make it happen. No, I want you to understand that that woman had to do something in order to receive what God had promised her. For you, you have been dreaming about this business, opening up your business, and you haven't even started on the blueprint. You haven't even started sending out proposals. You haven't even started, you know, telling people about it. Like, you haven't started putting in the work that's required. So for this message to come to pass, you are gonna have to do your part to make it happen. You're gonna have to do your part to make it happen. And for some people, you have been asking God, when are you gonna restore my child? When are you going to restore my marriage? And God is saying, about this time next year, about this time next year. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't go to counseling for your marriage. That means that you might need to start going to counseling. That means that you need to start taking the steps that God has been asking you to take in order for your breakthrough to come. But I'm certainly believing that about this time next year, about this time next year, your breakthrough will already be here. You will have received, you will have conceived your child. You will have received that promotion that seemed impossible to you. Because when we read in Genesis 18 and 14, it is saying, is anything impossible for God? God made a 99-year-old womb birth a son. God, even though Sarah laughed, even though to you it seems impossible, even though to you it seems funny, and you might be like the Shunam woman and say, don't deceive me. Don't deceive me. Don't raise up my hope. Don't give me an expectation, because I've been there. I've hoped. But when you were there last time and you hoped, did you do what it takes? Did you do what was required to get your breakthrough? Your breakthrough does not come from you just doing what you have done. About this time next year means you have to start spending time with God. You have to start doing what he is telling you to do. You have to start moving And I know you're like, well, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Get to stepping, right? Get to stepping. You're like, no, God hasn't. Get to stepping. It is often when we look back that we see where God has brought us from. You don't get to look back and see where you came from if you don't start taking your steps right now. So you have to start taking that step, and then God is going to order your next step. So about this time next year, I certainly receive it. I pray that that is a word for you and that you receive it. And as always, take this video back to the Lord. Pray about it. As always, He loves you. I love you. Be blessed.